Everyone is screaming Airbnbust on YouTube, on the news, everywhere. It's so easy to jump on the bandwagon and say Airbnb is dying. But I can tell you straight up that Airbnb bust is bullshit. And how do I know this? It's because I have over 450 Airbnbs myself, make over $1.2 million every single month, and have helped thousands of other people just like you working 9-to-5 get their own Airbnb, quit their job, and finally build a cash flowing business. And I can tell you, as someone who's been doing it for years, who's still gonna keep doing it for years until I die, the Airbnb bust isn't real. And I'm gonna tell you in this video exactly why. The first thing that I hear and see a lot of hosts talk about is too much oversaturation in their local market, which is true to a certain point. Overall, generally, almost every single market has more Airbnbs in the last 2 years, but that does not mean every single product type or bedroom type has experienced the exact same saturation levels. Let me explain. In Austin, for example, there's a huge oversupply, a giant influx of one bedroom, two bedroom, and even studio apartments. There's so much where hosts who have apartments in Austin, like myself, are not making any more money. But hosts who have houses are making more money than ever. My student Joby here has one house in Austin where the rent is $3,600 a month, and he's making $10,000 to $12,000 a month in revenue, almost $6,000 to $7,000 a month in profit. As the supply of apartments started skyrocketing and increasing, the supply of houses started decreasing because a lot of people who bought Airbnbs in the beginning of the last 2 years in Austin bought them on variable rates, floating loans, DSCR loans. And when the rates got too expensive, they weren't professional hosts, they weren't making a lot of money, they were forced to sell. And thus so, the supply of houses ended up decreasing. And also keep in mind, Austin is a city where a lot of people are traveling in groups of 8, 10, 12, even 16. The days of a husband and wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, 2 or 3 people traveling to Austin are a lot lower than what it was 2 or 3 years ago. So is the market of Austin saturated? Yes. Is there ways to make lots of money in Austin? Yes. Because you have to understand, not all product types are gonna have the same level of saturation as the rest. So do some research, figure out what qualifies as saturation in your market, whether it's one bedrooms, two bedrooms, three bedroom houses, two bedroom apartments, studios, with pools, without pools. Figure out what that saturation is, stay away from it, and do the exact opposite. And the second one that I hear a lot of hosts complain about is regulation. Take a look at this screenshot. This is the supply on Airbnb for one of the cities that I currently have Airbnbs in. The supply dropped off like a cliff because of regulation. Just overnight, over the last few months, hundreds and hundreds of Airbnbs have completely left this entire city because of regulation, where now the supply is almost the same as what it was 2 or 3 years ago. This is great for me because overnight, a lot of host accounts were completely shut down and couldn't list anymore as soon as that regulation came into effect. But someone like me, someone who's smart, who knew it was coming, got all my permits, all my licenses, and got everything that I needed to make sure I was in compliance. Now in that city, I'm making more money than ever, simply because demand has stayed the same, if not increased, but supply is almost cut in half back to 2021 level. So anyone in that market is making more money now than ever. Regulation is a good thing because it stops someone like me who can come into your market and grab 50 units, or any Joe Schmo off the street who can grab 5, 10, 20 apartments without anything blocking them or anything stopping them. Generally speaking, the cities that have the most regulations are the most profitable. The cities that have no regulations barely make any money. Now, the third thing that people talk about is that there's too much competition now in the market, which is entirely true. Airbnb properties that I had 3 years ago that I furnished with $3,000 IKEA furniture have not made money in the last few months. Now, those units have completely let go, and I've mainly been focusing on getting higher-end luxury A-class units that I'm spending $10,000 to furnish an apartment versus $3,000 2 or 3 years ago. Spending the money now for design is the most important thing. Competition is only gonna get tougher. You have to level up your design, level up your creativity, add more amenities, add a hot tub, trampoline, sauna, anything and everything you can think of to make sure you can attract as many people as possible. Competition is good. It makes you level up your business. Otherwise, if you stay complacent, you're gonna be losing money every single year. And then the next one is really funny. Everyone's screaming that economics collapse is upon us. So in reality, in hindsight, on a macro level, yes, generally people do have less disposable income right now than when they did during 2021, when people were getting free money from the government, CERB checks everywhere, CRA was giving away a lot of free money to everybody. Those days are long gone. But what hasn't changed is that people who have money are making more money now than ever. Rich people have money now more than any time in the last 4 or 5 years because the opportunities have only gone higher. People who don't have money are basically people who are working regular 9-to-5 jobs, people who are affected by layoffs, especially in tech. For business owners, this is a great time because a lot of businesses have been making more money than ever. Just in my friend circle alone, a lot of people are making $1 million, $2 million 2 or 3 years ago, and are now making $8 million, $10 million, some are even making $15 million a year. So in short, the economy is not good for broke people. The economy is great for people like me who are already making lots of money, that want to travel with their family, who don't think about price, that want to book that luxury apartment, a luxury house, and go have a nice time and travel all around the world. And finally, the most most important point that I want to discuss is people complaining that Airbnb is not scalable. When I hear that, that's when I know somebody hasn't figured out how to remove themselves from the business. They're still a day-to-day operator. They're not an owner. I have 450 Airbnb arbitrage apartments. I spend a maximum of 2 hours a week running the entire business. I have delegated, outsourced, used automation, used AI, set up systems, softwares, VAs, hired COO. I have done everything possible to remove myself from the entire business. That way, I am an owner and not an operator working in the day-to-day, worrying about every small little detail. I have no idea what happens in a day-to-day. All I look at and focus at is high income revenue producing tasks. So no, Airbnb is not going to go bust anytime soon. In fact, I'm more bullish on Airbnb this year than I ever have previously. That's why literally right now, as we speak, my team is furnishing 30 new apartments. Right now, we're in April of 2024. And just this month, I'm going to do $1.6 million in revenue. I'll take home at the very minimum $400,000 to $500,000 in pure net profit. So if you found this video useful and you're inspired by starting your own Airbnb business and quitting your 9-to-5 and finally gaining some financial freedom, then I may have something for you. I have a community where I help people just like you start Airbnb arbitrage. It covers exactly how to start from zero and get your first property within the first 2 weeks, how to scale it all the way to 50 plus units, and most importantly, how to remove yourself from the entire business and automate everything, build out everything to actually be an owner and not an operator. So then you can finally achieve the passive income that you've been dreaming of. If that sounds like something you're interested in, click the link in the description and you can book a call with me and my team, and we'll see if you're a good fit to join my Airbnb Accelerator program. As always, make sure you're subscribed for more content related to Airbnb arbitrage, and I'll see you guys in the next one.